Okay, so I wanted to make a quick video for everyone on how to use short and long-term fuel trims in your diagnostics. Vehicles are pre-programmed to change the amount of fuel injector on time and therefore the amount of fuel being delivered to the engine based on load and RPM changes. Okay, and those programmed settings are great, but since things are constantly changing out here, our vehicles are using sensors to give it updated information on what we can do better with our fuel delivery. So short and long-term fuel trims are what the computer is actually doing on top of the pre-programmed numbers that are in it. Okay, so right now, O2 sensors, mass airflow, and those kinds of things are feeding the computer information and telling it to either add or take away fuel. And the short-term fuel trims are what the computer is doing right now in response to that information. So we can see we have a short-term fuel trim for bank one and a short-term fuel trim for bank two. And you can see it's constantly making these slight changes, either taking away going into the negative or adding going into the positive. And notice these are percentages. Okay. Now, the fact that we're close to zero, this is really good. That means that our pre-programmed settings are doing just fine and we're not needing to make many adjustments on top of that. Okay, now, but let's say the short-term fuel trim was consistently adding 10% in order for the vehicle to run good. What would happen is the short-term fuel trim would pass on that information onto long-term fuel trim. And long-term fuel trim, you can think of as long-term memory. It's saying, hey, 10% has been doing us good, so now let's make that our new baseline number. So take your pre-programmed settings that we already have at this load and this RPM, add in this extra 10%, and let's make that our new baseline numbers. And then what short-term fuel trim will do after that is it will go back to trimming off of those new updated numbers. And you can see that's already happened here because our long-term fuel trim on bank one is at 14% consistently, and long-term fuel trim on bank two is at 11%. So this vehicle has found out that at this load and this RPM, this vehicle runs better with this much percentage more fuel. And now the short-term is just kind of doing small adjustments based on that. All right, so now I want to show you how you can actually use this when you're encountered with a problem. So let's say you have some sort of a drivability issue and you plug in your scan tool and you pull up your short and long-term fuel trims. What if you saw that your short-term fuel trims were both really, really high and your long-term fuel trims were both really, really high? What that proves is that your computer is trying to add a bunch of fuel in order to compensate for some sort of a lean condition, whether it be a vacuum leak or a miscalculated mass airflow sensor or O2 sensor problem. Either way, you can see what the computer is doing to try to compensate for something. Same thing if you saw them both in the negative, you'd see the computer trying to take away fuel for a rich condition, and then you could go after that. Now, the other really cool thing is once I find a problem, I can use these to prove that I actually fixed it. Okay, if I come in here after my repair and I see that the long-term fuel trims are still high, for example, but now my short-term fuel trims are really low in the negatives, then I prove that I fixed the problem because now the computer is trying to work its way back to baseline numbers. And slowly those negative numbers will feed into the long-term and these numbers will slowly get back to zero and you know that you fixed the problem. Okay, so short-term and long-term fuel trims are really useful. They take a little bit of practice. You're going to need to be looking at them on known good vehicles and then take a look at them on vehicles that are giving you difficulties. And the more you do that, the more you're going to be able to understand what's going on here and be able to use it in your diagnostics.